this was created from scratch, and now 4 months this is where it is. That's very impressive. Very impressive.
Recording that?
Was I in your way?
Nah,
that's why. I'm just avoiding Ant's head.
Easy thing to do.
Oh yeah.
In the next 2 weeks, we're implementing co-op, and we're trying to go into early access on Steam so that we can have people like you two, if you download it, you'd be able to play together, and we'd have more objectives to be able to further down the road. So we set up the and then the future of it, we've got PvP into it, so things like guilds and being able to do. The way we've done it is create a periodic table or a fantasy one. So like the hierarchy, instead of pushing the science of hierarchy, we're pushing the fact that hierarchy is full of stars. So we can make a character that creates black holes to suck enemies in. Things like that, and like instead of a fireball or a yellow, like some kind of plasma like galaxy or something like disturb the atmosphere. Instead of it just being like, oh, you breathe oxygen, it'll be a lot of like, being able to let people create jokes and silence different spells and stuff. So, I wanted it to be like when you play World of Warcraft, you have to like look between who do you want to be, like you're stuck with everyone now, what is it? 10 level sorcerer, you're stuck with that, and if you want to change, you'll move out, go back in, change, and there, and it will really give us the answer. So, we thought, why not be able to like choose three or four different rules that you want? You can then choose if you want to have a tank, if you want to have a healer, if you want to have a raid, DPS healer, just to focus on. Then you can choose what you want to play. So, then, it's going to benefit in your style of it. We can bring people in this, like, they'll have their own team. So, if they come up against somebody, say, for example, team lives in right now, they've got a four realm and they've got a fire up, they're like, shit, you need to try and counter that. So then someone in your team, like, if you want to make somebody who's kind of higher up, you'll want to also have somebody in your party at all times who can counter whatever counters you, so that it's a really tactical way of balancing up people. So the way we're doing the PvP in the future is we're going to bring in the rest of the side of the game as a core, but more of an open world mode, dynamic events. We want it to be an RPG game inside a PvP world.
Yeah.
So it's sort of set to defend the zone, but instead of them being bored with something up to them, there'll be events going on where they might have to collect items around the area while defending their zone or whatever, and then things will jump their own big legends, and maybe like a big boss is going to be on the every team, so then everything will stop and everybody will come together and there'll be a big fight that goes on. That boss might give you like really sick, but it will also give you a book for the duration of that particular match or something like that. And then somebody else on your team, their job is to focus on pushing them to try and make them come back so that your person can take out all these nice quests to get rewards. Honestly, we want like nice enough playing where maybe you start in your guild just wants to push straight forward and attack them. They might send two people out to do quests and they're like, oh shit, and they'll come from behind and then. So we want to, like, I do a lot of the environment design, so there's so many like sick ideas we have to have to do, like height advantages and what we could do to make it so I don't know, maybe we've got like catapults and then your team have to go and destroy that to get into like a game or something like that. So
it's very intuitive.
A lot of like esports platforms, so you said the market's missing something, and I think we found it. We're like, yes, you have.
You can do it.
Exactly. So, like, although it's ambitious, the reason it's ambitious is because we know we can do it.
I think it is different than anything on the market, because a lot of like MOBA games or MOBA style games use a lot of common gameplay elements that you notice throughout. Even if they look different, the concept of gameplay is still inherently the same.
It all comes from one game anyway.
You might have like your own little squad, but you might be able to have like four squads, so instead of having four characters, you'll have four squads, or you can switch characters between and choose, like, you can always sort of change, so if you've got like a healer in your squad, but you can try it on whatever. the legend or smite every time you start yourself at level 1 million, yeah. You have to buy your items. So we want to do it where the single player mode and the core mode are kind of like you can jump over. You'll be completing a story and daily quests, but at the same time that'll be getting you items based on your level.
So you'll be
matched against somebody who's like level 15. Unless you go into like a private guild, be a guild coach, you can go up against him, you choose stuff. If you do a public match where like there was 3 of my mates together, where we can be level 5, we'll only fight people who are between like level 5 and 8. So it'll be like a set kind of level group. So then there's no real advantage, everyone's got the same kind of gear. There's so much that we can do with it, because it's more like player versus player group online is where it's at nowadays. Like, that's what it is.
Oh yeah, it is annoying. But actually, that's one of the nice balances of the story, because I've heard a lot of people who like the story is more about than going online.
That's a bit like, a lot of people would be like, oh, I wouldn't be interested in online mode. And I'm just like, oh, that's good, I'll tell you about the story instead. So we kind of, what about it? That was basically, the brief of the story is like, these four characters, they're all, that's four races, they're fighting on this particular island. Because of how we've done it, these four races.